Hello, everyone. So, my next guest is the insanely talented Jonah Platt. So, Jonah, you are, I'd say, best known for Wicked, playing Fiero. Mm-hmm. And so how did that come about? Tell us about the process of the interview and all the audition and sort of how you felt when you got the part.
Well, they had reached out to me a little bit before to see if I was interested in auditioning for the tour. They reached out through my agent. And at that time, it wasn't something I was able to do. But then about a year later, after I had done a little bit more work in Los Angeles, they reached out and asked if I wanted to audition for Broadway. So I did. I put together a tape. They had me do the basic Fiero audition, which is two songs, two scenes from the show. And I put together that tape with the help of some friends, sent it in, and a little while later found out I had booked the part. And it was so exciting. I remember getting that phone call. I was driving to meet my then girlfriend, now wife, for lunch. And I like pulled over and was just ecstatic. And I was so excited to share the news with her when I got to lunch. It was amazing.
That's exciting. And you worked with Rachel Tucker, who is an insanely talented Elphaba. I've seen videos of her. She is amazing. She's done, is it Broadway and West End?
That's for sure, yeah. She's done a lot of work. She was actually had just come back to New York to do Come From Away on Broadway. I don't know if she started or not before this whole COVID nonsense, but I know that was what was next on her agenda. But yeah, she and I came into Wicked at the same time and we left at the same time. It was she and I all the way, which was a
thrill. It would be nice to keep the same sort of
pairing. Yeah, it was nice to go through that together.
So recently they did a re-showing of Jesus Christ Superstar, which you were in.
Yes, they did it on Easter Sunday, just a few days ago.
And you worked with, was it John Legend and Sarah Bareilles who were the...
For sure.
And yeah. How was that? That must have been pretty exciting to be like...
It was great. I mean, they were lovely. They were really wonderful to work with and very, obviously, insanely talented and very professional and very focused and dedicated to what they were doing. Most of my day in and day out work was with the rest of the ensemble. You know, we brought in John and Sarah really within the last week or two. Once we really moved into the space and started doing all the camera blocking and all that stuff, then they kind of really had to be on all the time.
And that, so yeah. And speaking of Sarah Bareilles, if anyone hasn't seen, Jonah's got a version of You Matter to Me on YouTube, which is one of the best versions I've seen. So
thank you. Well, a lot of that is due to my partner in that song, Caitlin Airy, who is a fantastic singer.
Okay. So something that a lot of people will know you for is your sneaky little cameo in The Office.
Yes.
Where you played, did your character have a name or was it just Frat Guy?
Frat Guy.
I saw that and I was like, this is amazing. And yeah. How'd that come about?
It came about because I had used to work for the showrunner of the show on The Office a couple of years before they got to the finale. And they kind of wanted that series finale to have a real sort of family feel to it. And I think when they got to that role, like a light clicked in their head. They're like, oh my God, like Jonah's an actor. He'd be perfect for this part. We got to call Jonah and bring Jonah in to do this. So
you are perfect for the part.
And thank you. Yeah, it was really fun. And I get people all the time who are like binging that show or rewatching it and they get to the finale and they're like, oh my God, there you are.
I think the best thing I saw was when I was watching it on YouTube, I saw in the comments people being like, wait, that's you? Which was quite funny.
Yeah.
Today, I was watching your, and I got this wrong a couple of times when I was speaking to you before the interview, but I'm getting it right this time. I was watching your I Want Melody, which
yes.
is the songs in musicals where the character's talking about what they want. And you arranged that yourself, didn't you?
I did indeed, yes. I had a little bit of help, of course, from my musical director to sort of help it make sense musically, but the whole map of what went where and how was what my arrangement.
And do you do a lot of your own arranging when it comes to medleys?
I do, yeah. Every time I do a big solo show, I love to try to do a new medley. They take a lot of work and time, but I've done a, there's online, there's a 90s TV theme song medley that I did in a show that you can see online, and my I Want medley. And I don't know if it's still online, but for my friend's book release, I did a medley of like empowerment songs. That was really fun also. I love doing that kind of stuff.
So everyone out there, check out Jonah's medleys, because they are amazing. I've seen a few
of them.
Thank you. People who are watching who know me might not know this, but one of my favorite movies ever is Trolls. And when the series came out, you were approached, weren't you, to play, the character's name is Milton Moss, right?
Yes, correct.
And so tell us about the character in the show. Like,
that was sort of a dream job come true for on a voiceover perspective. I actually auditioned for the part of Branch, and I got down to the final two. It was me and Skylar Astin, and obviously he's a little bit more famous than I am and very talented. And they, you know, has done a tremendous job, but it got me sort of on their radar a little bit. And when the part of Milton came around, they had me sort of audition for parts here and there all the time. They would always sort of call me in, and the part of Milton came around, and it was just a perfect fit. I feel very comfortable playing really nice guys. Milton was a lot of fun to do, a little sort of Trolls, Mr. Rogers kind of feel. And it was supposed to, when I first did it, I thought it was just going to be one episode, and ended up being, you know, like seven or eight, which was such a gift. And I got to keep recording, you know, I was in a number of different seasons there, and really a wonderful experience.
So, I've just lost my train of thought. I was going to ask you something. Of course, A Walk on the Moon. You were just supposed to be in that, weren't you? And then it was crazy. Pandemic happened.
So we did the world premiere of it in San Francisco 2 years ago. And they've reworked the show a bit and recast a bunch of the roles and put a lot of work into it. And we were ready to do what we hoped would be our final out-of-town tryout before Broadway. And then, of course, coronavirus hit, so now we're on hold. But the show is just postponed, not canceled. And once things get back up and running again, we will be doing this production at the George Street Theater in New Jersey, whenever that may be, hopefully sometime early 2021.
So everyone buy tickets when that finally, all this pandemic is over.
Follow me on social media or check out my website, and you'll be able to know what's going on.
And your website is
jonahplatt.com. JonahPlatt.com, and you can join. I have a newsletter on there, which I don't send out a lot, but anytime I book a big gig or have a new thing coming up, I'll send out an email so you can have all the details.
Okay, cool. Just a couple more things. The TV show you worked on, you did a song for it, didn't you? A Million Little Things, and the song was called Unexpected. It's a
beautiful song. So thank you so much.
How did they approach you for that?
Right, so my friend is the composer for that show. And he scores the show and writes the original songs on that show. And that song came along, and they needed a lot of the songs he himself will record, or he'll have his daughter actually has been on a couple recordings, but they wanted somebody for this one that wasn't his voice, that had a more sort of contemporary pop rock sound. And he immediately thought of me and said, this would be really fun. Would love to have you sing on this. And we banged it out really quick, and he wrote a great song. It was really fun to sing, and another just a great opportunity that I was really lucky and excited to have.
And everyone check out that song as well, because it's also a great song.
Yeah, you can listen to it wherever you stream your music. And just, you can search my name, you search Unexpected, you search A Million Little Things, you can find it.
Okay, cool. So these are the last two sort of fun questions I asked John Montague in my last interview. So this first question is, musical theatre songs. If you could be in any show singing any musical song, and you didn't have to be like guy or girl, just being up there in like just doing anything, which song would you be like, I want that one, I want that to be my song?
Oh, man. That's a tough one. Any musical theatre song ever. Put me on the spot with that. I don't know. I can't name if I can only pick one, so I'll just say one that would be fun to sing. Would be, I guess. I mean, Elphaba's pretty awesome. If I could do like No Good Deed, that would be pretty sweet.
That's a good song.
Yeah.
And Elphaba, I love any song that you can sort of belt and just be like, yeah, just.
Yeah, No Good Deed is, I really enjoy that song. I love all the different sort of dark twists and turns and builds, and it's just great, great fun.
Would it feel weird though, belting your previous character's name?
Yeah, that would be fun too. Just getting to shout Fiera, that'd be great.
Scream Fiera into the darkness. And the final sort of fun question before we do our closing is, if you could be any Disney princess, which one would you be?
If I could be any Disney princess, which one would I be? Well, I mean, does Mulan count?
I'd say Mulan counts.
Yeah, I mean, who wouldn't want to be Mulan? She, you know, saves an entire country and does her family proud and, you know, is a badass fighter. She can do it all.
That's a good choice.
Yeah.
Thank you. So I think what I'm going to finish on, same thing I sort of finished on with John Monty last time, is going to be, what's your advice for people that are at home now, that are all bored and they're just feeling maybe the stress or the anxiety of being trapped?
That's a great question. I think, and I've discovered a little bit of this myself, is you have to just sort of do the things you would do if you weren't trapped. So if what you love to do is have dinner with your friends, make a FaceTime date with your friends, cook your dinners, you can coordinate, you can order from the same place or cook the same thing. You can even one of you get the takeout and go drop it at your friend's flat and have dinner together on FaceTime. If your favorite thing to do is go to the movies, make it fun for yourself, like turn all the lights off, pop some popcorn, and watch a movie at home. It just takes a little bit of extra effort or thinking, but I think we have these mental blocks where like, oh, I'm stuck at home, so I can't do anything. But you really can still kind of do everything in a way if you're willing to just sort of push past that, oh, it's not the same because I'm not there in person. But you really can have the same emotional experience and like connection with people and stuff, even without being there. So I think just do the things that made you happy before all this, do them now, and you'll be surprised at how much you can still enjoy them.
Okay, thank you for that amazing advice. Thank you everyone for joining in the interview with Jonah. This interview, by the way, is to try and raise money for Acting for Others. So I'm gonna post a link to it, just giving in the description. And if you can all like donate anything, just even if it's like £1 or 50p, as long as any donation, it just counts. It all sort of builds up and adds together.
I think it's great that you're raising money for that. I think a lot of people don't really think about actors or entertainment as, you know, being affected in these kinds of situations, or as being, you know, a class of work that is worth donating money towards. But think about all the things that you're enjoying while you're in quarantine, all the TV shows and the concerts and the movies. And like the people who put those on and bring you that enjoyment are these actors who their entire industry has shut down and they cannot do really any work at all except what they can do for fun from their homes. So really a lot of actors are struggling to stay afloat through all this. So any help at all really, really makes a difference and this can sort of be your way of giving back to all the great content you're getting to enjoy. Think about the actors who are wishing that they could be, you know, performing live for you now, but can't, and give them a little extra help.
Thank you. So you guys heard it from the superstar himself. Ah. Everyone donate if you can, as much or as little as you can to Acting for Others. And thank you, Jonah, for being part of this interview.
It's my pleasure, Tom. Amazing. Thank you for having me.
No worries. So thank you. Goodbye, everyone.
Bye. And if you want to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, I'm at Jonah Platt. Website is jonahplatt.com. And my YouTube is youtube.com/JonahPLA.
And you all should, because he is one of the best.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. See you next time.